Outdoor Adventures Productions brings you this week's Bayou Country Outdoors. With your host, Susan Melton, and Maurice Fontenot. And now it's time for this week's Bayou Country Outdoors.
Well, folks, welcome to this week's Bayou Country Outdoors. Susan and I decided to take the afternoon off and go out and do a little bit of bass fishing. The weather is absolutely great today. A little cloud cover, a little bit windy, but the weather's warm. So we grabbed our well-built boat, and we headed out. And folks, y'all stay tuned. Right after these messages, we'll get to fishing Bayou Country Outdoors.
What do you have?
I got this one right here at the boat. I stopped that spinnerbait. Oh, that's a nice one.
Very nice.
Man, I stopped that spinnerbait and it fell, and when it did, I saw him run up there and grab it. Okay. You might have to throw the spinnerbait. That's two back to back on that. Fuss, it had to be a female.
Yeah, right. Like men don't fuss.
Men don't
ladies.
Fuss.
Like men don't fuss.
We grumble.
Hmm.
Do we fuss? Come on, turn around, look at your wife and ask her right now, mm-hmm. Do you fuss?
Right.
And to get prepared to get the duck because something's coming your way.
Mm-hmm.
You gonna stay on that worm?
Yeah, I'm staying on my worm. You better know it. I like my worm, so let's see if I can catch something on it like you did, huh?
Folks, she usually tears my tail up on those worms, and I've got two on the spinnerbait, but
well,
that's...
we just started.
Well, yeah.
Give me a break.
Well, you were on the rattle trap for a little while, too.
Yeah, I was experimenting with the rattle trap and didn't catch anything, so I'm going to try this worm.
What do you think this overcast is going to do?
It ought to be a pretty good day. Actually, it ought to be really good, you know, with the overcast. They ought to be looking up. Huh?
Yeah, I think so. That's why that spinnerbait, I believe, is working.
Yeah. Well, if I don't get anything on this worm, then I will definitely try the spinnerbait.
Well, fish that worm for a minute. You just started it, so.
Yeah. Got some others fishing over there.
Foot control. Oh, fish.
I could see the
all
fish.
All right. I went to that spinnerbait, and that seemed to make a difference. I threw that crankbait for a little bit, and nothing. You want to touch him for luck, huh?
No, that's okay.
All right.
It's your luck.
Good deal, guy. You hit on back in there.
Susan, I think I got a white. I do. I have a white perch on a spinnerbait. Look at here.
Well, good. Ladies, white perch out here. Great.
And I took that catch net and threw it in the back of the truck. I don't have anything to put these guys in.
Oh, yeah, we can keep the white perch.
When I saw his side come up, I said, I think I got a big old crappie.
Pretty. All right.
If we were keeping fish, you'd be a fry pan, I tell you.
Oh, yeah.
You'd be in the fry pan. That'll be something sitting in these troughs right here. There's deeper water. This overcast ought to have them looking up. You know, like it's going to be opening up soon. We'll be able to take this well-built boat in there. And look at here. Oh, good fish. Good fish. Look at that. Oh!
You were supposed to bring it in the boat.
You've got to go to a spinnerbait. You've got to. What I was getting ready to say is Lycosine's opening up in April. And they tell me this year there is going to be a tremendous number of white perch, crappie, sackalay, whatever part of the country you're in, and you hear that. So we're kind of going to get geared up for that. We'll go out there with light tackle and heavy tackle. And I got a knot in my line. That fish caused me a knot.
Oh, you poor thing.
Now, folks, if you ever get a knot in monofilament line, you take it out because that'll cut the working strength of that line down tremendously. Matter of fact, the next fish you catch, it'll probably break at that knot. I see a lot of people out there fishing, especially kids, they'll have a knot in their line and then they finally catch a fish that breaks off. Not that we don't ever lose fish. And then always check that line too. Susan, I continually tell people to check the line, and I just knotted it again, so I'm gonna retie anyway. I've been fishing in stumps. Nice fish I just lost, huh?
Yeah, that was a nice fish.
You on spinnerbait now, huh?
Yeah.
Okay,
good.
Haven't
caught anything yet.
Well, you had a bump a minute ago, because that's all you set the hook.
I didn't set the hook.
Oh. You're trying to fool me, huh?
No, I just have gotten into some grass. But I did feel a bump, but I didn't set the hook. That's why I didn't get it. So, like, I just felt something then. But I might have been going through.
Lively.
Lively.
You like this warmer weather, don't you?
So what are you on, the spinnerbait?
No, I went to this little baby bandit, little bandit crankbait.
So actually today's the day where you just kind of change your baits around and see if they're biting on, because they don't stay at one pattern.
Well, I think we got out of the area where those fish were sitting on those mounds for spawning, and this is a little deeper water. That's why I went to this, but... I usually do pretty good with this in the spring. It's this baby bandit. He's missing an eye. Look, the fish took his eye off.
Oh.
It's a one-eyed. That's why he got him. He's crippled. He knows he got an easy bite there.
Uh-huh.
You got Wendy's cup. Where's your cup? You got a Wendy's cup. And she's got a Subway sandwich. You better explain.
Well, you picked the drink up for me, and then we decided we'd eat fresh at Subway. Yeah.
The Subway sandwiches, and folks, they're not a sponsor, but the Subway sandwiches are really good out on the water. Just stick them in the ice chest, and it's like having a great big fresh chef salad, really.
Mm-hmm. It's good.
Nice to take a break, too.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, you know what? They said it was going to be 59 degrees today.
Oh,
cloud cover, and folks, I tell you, it's about 75 or better.
Mm-hmm.
We got the cloud cover starting in, which ought to help the fishing right now. Not too much is going on. That's why we're taking a break to eat, but it ought to pick up here in a few minutes. If not, we're gonna have to go to Plan B, aren't we? Susan sitting there wondering, what's plan B?
I'm not throwing the rest of my sandwich in.
That's plan B.
It's good, you know. Nothing yet. Nothing yet. Come on, maybe by that stump. Come on, give me a fish.
All right.
Come on, do a fancy little jump for me.
You just switched over to that worm, didn't you?
Yeah.
Now, they slowed down on the spinner baits and the crank baits, and we figured, well, maybe, Susan said, maybe if we go on back to the worm, we can find something. And you did right off the bat. That's first cast for that worm, too.
Mm-hmm. Boy, he set the hook. It was just moving it slow. Darn, these hooks are good, huh? All right. There you go. There he goes. He's happy.
He's ready for that.
Oh, yeah. He's ready. I was ready for him. Okay, I'll fix this bait and go back out there again. Just rehook it. Okay, not bad, not bad.
That's that Berkeley tequila you got.
Yeah, Berkeley tequila just threw right here at the bank. And like I said, I just let it sit slow. I wasn't moving it fast.
Yeah, I think they're off the fast moving stuff.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Down, so.
Exactly.
Actually, when I saw you set the hook, the boat had almost drifted over your bait head.
Yeah. Pretty much, but I got him. It felt great. All right.
That's another good one on that, selling that worm, huh?
Yeah, this one's, whoa. Whoa, whoa.
I think we bumped into the bank up there.
I'm thinking so too. I hope I better give myself some slack here because. Oh. Okay. Boy, we've been setting them real good though with these hooks. Let me get my. Another good one. Hey.
Oh, yeah. Good fish.
Okay.
Nice and fat, aren't they?
Yeah, they are. They're nice and healthy looking. Healthy like us, huh?
You mean fat? Is that what you're saying? I'm not fat.
I'm going to try using it again. See if it'll work for another one. Time for some more of these, huh? I'm a lady. You whisper. We don't want the fish to know that we're here.
Don't disturb the fish.
It felt good. Same way that I got the others. Is just
it.
No, they're picking up. And then when I'm pulling, because I'm moving it slow, they're on it. That's
like
how I know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yep. That's the secret. Missed it. I didn't set it. That's how they're doing it, Maurice. They're grabbing it as I'm moving it. Let me see. Oh, and that one felt good. That one felt good. He may not have. It. But he felt great. To me, I felt him. Yeah, I felt you, dude. He was good. Gotta get to that right there. Yeah. Yeah, he's wrapped. Let's go to him. Sometimes they can't come to you, so you gotta go to them. Just keep your...
You missed that one, then went back on him, didn't you?
If it was the same one, yeah. I'm gonna get him. I hope I didn't like wrap him around. There he is, Sam.
He's still on there.
Oh, I'm gonna lose it. I'm gonna lose it. We're wrapped. I see him. Sam.
You see the fish? I see the fish.
Oh, man. We got too much stuff in this boat. It's the story of our life here. Where is he? You gonna let him?
I saw him. It's good fish.
Yeah, he was on there. Like I said, he's probably wrapped around that stump. Let's just lift the stump.
Sorry, a little trolling motor. Get over this limb.
The things we go through to get a fish, huh? Isn't that something? He was there to...
I guarantee you, he's played out.
He's a tired out fish, huh?
He might be off now. Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, well, he's gone. Just go ahead and cut it.
I'm not sure he's gone.
He's wrapped himself around the stump. Is he? All right, go ahead and take it off for me.
All right.
That was something.
Back this way.
That's a good fish.
Your lucky day, that's all I got to say.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. You throw him back in.
Okay. All right, I worked hard for him, huh? We both did. Teamwork. All right, that was good. That was good. See, you got to go to them sometimes. You can't expect them to go to you every time.
300 pounds of wet log.
Yeah, exactly. But it was nice, very nice. Lots of mossy grass here. Okay, I think that's been a good day, huh?
Yeah.
I think so.
Well, we had a good time. Just a couple hours out, and you know, enjoyed the fishing, enjoyed your company.
Yeah, we enjoyed everybody else's company. Well, folks, thanks for joining us today. We had a really good bass outing today. The weather was just perfect for it. Don't know how the weekend's going to be, but I think we had a really good trip. Thanks for joining us on Bayou Country Outdoors. I'm Susan. Remember, it's great being outdoors.
Thanks for tuning in to this week's Bayou Country Outdoors with your host, Susan Melton, and Maurice Fontenot. You can contact us by writing us at Outdoor Adventures Productions, 1019 Shady Lane, Westlake, Louisiana, 70669, or by calling 337-439-4063.